It's bloody hard to believe, but completely unconfirmed sources tell me David Hasselhoff was already atop the WA border wall warming up his pipes for the big Feb 5 opening. I've been looking for freedom. But last night, Mark McGowan made a decision that made the Hoff look downright silly.
Omicron has changed everything. Allowing hundreds or thousands of Omicron-infected people to fly straight into Perth from February 5 with no testing, no quarantine and no public health measures would cause a flood of COVID across our state. The hard border will stay.
This is a mess.
Feb 5 will still see some changes. West Australians with strong WA connections will be allowed back in. There's also allowance on compassionate grounds, including funerals, palliative care and terminally ill visitation. But you'll need to do 14 days self-quarantine, return negative RAT and PCR tests and have received your booster shot.
I know this decision will be unpopular with many people. For that, I am sorry.
Well, I think it's an entirely sensible decision.
Mark McGowan has always made the right call based upon health advice.
For those desperate for a family reunion, it's heartbreaking.
Like, I'm so devastated. I didn't sleep last night. I just feel so just devastated. I just don't know when this is going to end.
And for those championing the ramping up of the economy, it's enraging.
The tourism industry is reeling from the news. This morning we are processing thousands of cancellations of holiday bookings, tour bookings, event bookings.
This is the most extraordinary decision from an economic perspective. The damage to the Western Australian economy in the long term from this decision will be huge.
But there's still support among the many Western Australians locked in rather than out.
I think it's the most rational thing for the Premier to do.
We are happy. Keep the virus out.
Because we don't want to bring any disease to West Australia, the cleanest city in the world.
I have a lot of respect for what Mark did, not just for immunocompromised people, but the health system. If we can avoid having deaths, if we can avoid having cases, it's worth it.
While there's no new date for the border to come down, McGowan says they'll discuss it next month, hinting that an increase in the local rate of third shot booster jabs would help. Problem is,
we currently sit at 25.8% of third doses for everyone aged 16 and over. The let it rip strategy with low third dose vaccine levels doesn't work. It would be reckless and irresponsible to open up now. I can't do it.
Just get vaccinated. That'd be really nice.
I'm always in two minds about this kind of stuff because on the one hand, being on the East Coast and being in New South Wales, I can totally understand being in WA and not wanting to go through what New South Welsh people went through, right? Mm. And Victorians and the rest of the people on the East Coast. However, WA has had about 2 years to get its shit together. Yeah. And every other state and territory is opening up, even though their boost rates are, you know, they're comparable, a bit lower, but comparable. So why not you?
I think the problem is that in WA, it's going to take more than 2 years to fix the health system over there because there hasn't been enough investment in their hospitals and there are a few other mitigating factors. It's a big state, you know. It's much bigger than New South Wales, than Queensland. So the hospital services are only in certain places. So there's that geographic issue as well.
I think the health system wouldn't cope if they were overwhelmed with Omicron.
But why it is such an unpopular decision, which, you know, Mark McGowan himself would be like, he knows that it is going to be unpopular for people probably outside of Western Australia and everyone trying to get in there. But you heard from that lady there, get vaccinated. The state has got vaccinated. Like, you're right, Jan Fran. The vaccination rates there, they're not as great as places in Australia, but they are creeping up. They're creeping up. So I think that people are trying to do the right thing so that they can meet these goalposts, which continue to just shift, and now it's an indefinite shift.
Well, the thing is, people in WA vote for Mark McGowan.
That's right.
In New South Wales, we don't.
I'm starting to think that they, West Australians don't like the people over on the East Coast.
Yeah. Well, there has been talk of secession over the years.
I feel like it could be a very clever tourism Western Australia campaign, like a playing hard to get strategy, because all of a sudden now I'm not allowed to go there. I kind of want to, you know.
Oh! Yeah, that's not bad.